So let's take our hand and make the shape of a sphere. It's kind of like a sphere.
The Environmental Education and Outreach Mobile Classroom travels to schools, primarily elementary schools, statewide, teaching students about non-point source pollution, how it's impacting the water, and how they can make simple changes to improve the water quality in their communities.
I like to splish and splash.
We have a program, kindergarten through second grade, that is a multimedia puppet theater. And this program is a 30-minute program that is a very visual way for students to understand what happens in a little community when they have a great big rainy day.
Help, help, help us, please.
So Bobby Bass and his fish friends and Molly Mockingbird have a crisis on the river when the community began building new areas and construction, and they didn't think about their natural resources. Then they have a great big rainy day and all of that pollution ends up down in Bobby Bass's river pool. So the citizens learn how to do best management practices to improve their water quality in their community. Our third through fifth grade program is actually a PowerPoint presentation we call All the Water in the World. And this program helps students to understand from right when a rainstorm happens, how does water work? How does it move? What does it do as it moves? And we teach them how the water has properties. So the properties are causing pollution to stick, pull, dissolve, and carry into the waterways down to the Gulf of Mexico.
Well, we have a great big rainy day, right?
Students that live in the northern part of the state do not really understand anything about the Gulf of Mexico, and vice versa. So we try to help students connect to that. So we want them to understand the geography of where they are and also where all of that pollution is going. And we try to teach them that what they do with their litter affects everyone and everything around them.
How many of you know where the Ross Barnett?
We actually have curriculum that aligns with our program. So we have labs, we have lesson plans, we have activities, we have games and reviews, vocabulary, quizzes and tests. We also have lots of links to other resources with agencies and groups, not only statewide, but nationally. So we want to equip our teachers when they leave our program, this isn't just it. They're going to take materials home with them that are going to enable them to continue the process in the classroom. We don't want to make them really grossed out about going in the water, but we just want to inspire them to get them to understand what's happening. Because it's very important to the students in our state to realize that simple activities we do every day are impairing those watersheds. And those are the places where they're going fishing, swimming, boating, and it really could actually be even affecting their well water, their drinking supply.
Jesus, hope, how did all this stuff get down here to the river anyway?
We would like students to not litter in the first place. Our hope is to teach them how bad that litter is so they won't do it. The second thing is if they see litter on the ground, to make sure, of course, if there's an adult present, that they can pick it up and throw it away. The third thing is to recycle. We hope to inspire young audiences to become better water quality stewards in their community, to improve the water for them for the future.
Congratulations to Bayou Town Productions for its Environmental Education and Outreach Mobile Classroom, the first place Gulf Guardian Award winner in the Youth Environmental Education category.